open it. Customize this source data file. Actually, the daily basis you will get the input files in this Excel format. Yeah, so the Excel sheet one, we are going to have some number of records now. We have to give the grade for each student. Yeah, so we have to define the logic. So we have to automate this process. We have to collect all the students' information. Then we have to compare each student percentage value. Then we have to give the grade based on that mark what they have. Yeah, so this is our requirement. So if this is a business processing flow, now, so how you will automate it? So first we should know how to collect the data from Excel file. It is very important. Actually, Excel is a separate application, right? The Blue Prism, we are having two types of studios. One is the process studio and another one is that object studio. Business studio, process studio for applying business processing flow, and object studio for interacting with your business applications. So can we say that Excel is the business application, because maximum companies, they are using that Excel as their reporting purpose or for storing some input files or something. So the record storage purpose, we can use that Excel file. So Excel also application, right? So we have to interact with that Excel application, and then we have to collect the data from the particular sheet. So, but from the Blue Prism, directly we cannot interact with that any of the application. So we have to use that object file. Actually, in the Blue Prism, there are two types of objects. One is that predefined one, and another one is that user defined one. Predefined one means what are the objects providing by Blue Prism. Those objects you can say like that predefined objects. User defined object means, so we are going to create our business object based on our business application. Okay, so then for which type of application the predefined or the Blue Prism developed objects are available now? What are the applications you are using globally common purpose? For example, Excel or Word, these type of applications are globally they are using, and the features also common for all, right? Then in your company or my company and any of the company, everyone they are using the same feature, Excel only, right? So this type of application, and for example, another example, database. Suppose if you are using that SQL Server database in your business application or Oracle database in your business application, you have to connect with that application. So actually you have to define some logic for connecting with your database, right? This connecting concept is common for all, right? In India, in UK, in US, everywhere they are going to use that the same way, only they are going to connect with the database, right? The data will be changed, the username, password, it will be changed, but the method of connection with the database is so common. So these type of common task or common application, so they provided predefined objects. Okay. So the same way for Excel also, they provided predefined objects. Okay. So the where we can find that predefined object in your system or in your server environment. Okay. So the Blue Prism installed, once installed in your system or in your environment, server environment, the predefined objects will be available in that environment's local path. See, go to the C drive and go to the program files, and the Blue Prism limited folder will be available. Blue Prism limited folder, when it will be available? Once you install the Blue Prism in your environment, the Blue Prism limited folder available, and the Blue Prism automate will be available. So in this Blue Prism automated folder, you can see some n number of folders and files. From here you have to choose that VBO. VBO here, that stands for Visual Business Object. Actually, the object studio, we will say like that one, VBO. The each object is called VBO, Visual Business Object. So in this Visual Business Object, you can see all the predefined objects. So these are the predefined objects. See, you can see that one predefined object, the name of MS Excel VBO, right? MS Excel, MS Excel. So if you are going to use that Excel file in your processing flow, now first you have to import this MS Excel object into your Blue Prism. By default it will be available in local path. You have to import it. See, go to that one, go to the Blue Prism, and this is the main window. Suppose if you are going to import that any of the file, whether it is process file or object file, you have to import it. If you want to import now, you have to go to the main window. The main window having that file menu. Actually, this file menu option available in process file also, but this is for separate purpose. Okay. Suppose if you are going to import that any of the object or process now, you have to import it from the main window files option. So go to the file, click, and you can see that one option import. Import, and you have to browse it where that object is available. You have to navigate to the path. So browse it, and this is our path, the same path what you have seen now. The same path, and from this place you have to choose it, MS Excel, and then open it, and then next. See, in my Blue Prism, in my server, my database, already the MS Excel VB was imported. Now again I am trying to import that file. So it's asking like that, overwrite the existing business object with the incoming business object. So if you are selecting this one, your existing Excel object will be overwrite. Okay? And assign a new ID and rename the incoming business object. So if you want to rename it now, then you can choose that one. So don't import this business object. I don't want to already, because already I'm having, so I don't want to import this one. Then you have to choose the second one. I'm going to select the first one because I didn't apply any changes in the existing one. The same one only. I'm going to override it and then click the finish. Now it will be available. Whatever the object you are importing, that imported objects will be listed under the Object Studio's default group. The default group. This is your MS Excel VBO. See today's date. It's all right. Modification. Clear? So this is the way you have to import the MS Excel VBO. So whenever you are going to use that Excel file processing automation, now you have to use, you have to import MS Excel VBO if it is the first time now. Right? Then. So I have imported and I'm going to create them. The same process I'm going to use it for this. And then Excel data process, the page I have created, and then fine. Now actually in this page I'm going to define the logic for collecting data from Excel. Right, data from Excel. Now first, the Excel, it's a separate application. For the purpose only we have imported that MS Excel VBO. That MS Excel VBO, now it's available in the Blue Prism environment, the Blue Prism server. Now you are going to use that MS Excel object into the process. That means you are going to call that object file into the process file. So how we can call one object into process? We have to call it, right? How we can call the object into process? So here the answer is using action stage. Using action stage, we can call any object into the process. So I'm going to use that action stage. This is action stage, and double click on that one. The property window is opened. The property window of action stage, you can see two drop down list. One is that business object, another one is that action. Right? Before that one, just close it. We will open that MS Excel object which is we imported, right? This is the, just open it. This is called Object Studio. This is the MS Excel VBO object. This Object Studio also same like a Process Studio. Okay, so these tabs are called action. Each tab is called pages or subsheet or subpage, right? All are tabs only, but in the process side it is called subpage or subsheet. In the same way, the object side, each tab is called action, right? The action, the each action, they have different something relevant to Excel logics. Okay, so these all are called actions. Then go to the Process Studio. Here I'm going to call that object into the process. Open it. The business object drop down list, you can see all the objects, whatever the objects you have created or imported under the Object Studio, everything will be listed in this objects in the business object drop down list. See, all the objects are listed, and our object that MS Excel VBO, actually it was imported under the default folder, right? The folder name will be highlighted like this, and you can see that the bold name, and under the each bold, the each bold representing our group name, and under the each bold value, so each one is called process, object file, and our object file will be available under the default group, and this is our object. You have to select it, right? I have selected, I have created, and then see, once you select the relevant object, now that object's actions will be populated here automatically. What are the actions we have seen just now? All those objects are listed here. What are the actions published in that object? Those actions only will be listed. Some objects can have that unpublished actions. So here all the published action will be listed. From this place you have to choose what action you have to use it, right? So this is the way we can call our object into process, or object's action into process. Clear? Fine. But here there is a lot of actions are there, right? Which action we have to use it if you are going to use the Excel file? Which action we have to first, which action we have to select the first one? See, the standard way, first that should be a three steps or two steps you have to follow it by default. One is that create instance, another one is that open workbook. Create instance for what? Simple way, you are initiating that Excel in the memory of Blue Prism, the internal purpose. Because if you are not creating instance for your Excel, then you cannot open your workbook. Actually, even though if you are using the physical file, that workbook is available in that Excel application only, right? So that should be a first step, create instance for your Excel. You have to create it. So for creating instance, already actions are created, actions are defined. I'm using that action, I'm going to create the instance. That's what I'm giving the name for this action, create instance, and creating instance. Creating instance for Excel, and what object name? That MS Excel VBO. See, there's a lot of action. Create instance and so on. Select that one. Create instance. You don't want to give any input, and the create instance action will give one output. That output in this type of number. So it is one action. That action finally giving one output value. So if you are getting value, you have to store that value into the data item. So I don't know that any data item for that instance output. I'm going to create it. You can give any name here. Otherwise, you can click this button. One data item will be created in this name, default one. Handle. This handle. See, this is a handle. The handle. Once you execute this stage, this handle will get the value. This handle is nothing but this is the reference for your instance. The instance is nothing but it's the internal memory or initiating of our Excel. Now you are having that internal memory or instance for your Excel. So in that internal instance, you can open your workbook. Actually, without using instance, that means without initiating Excel, we cannot use that Excel workbook. So that we are using that create instance as a first step. So now we are having instance, right? Then I have created instance. Created, then. If you are having that Excel application, in that Excel application you can create or open your workbook. So open workbook is the second one. Already I am having that workbook here, right? So copy the path and go to this one, open it, just giving open workbook. opening Excel workbook, and for open there is an action, the name of open workbook. It is asking input in which memory or which instance you are going to open this workbook. That in that instance reference we are having in the data item handle, right? This is the instance. In this instance or in this memory or this in this environment, I am going to open the file. Which file? You have to mention the file name with a proper path. This is the path. This is a text type, so that I am giving double quotes. So this is the file, I am going to open it in this memory. So you have to refer the file. For the purpose, this action will give the output, the name of workbook name. So the same name I am going to use it, the workbook name. It is a separate data item, it is a text type, that is what I created under the text. So this is the data item for referring your open book, which is opened in that memory, right? Now you have created instance, and in that instance you have opened your workbook, then you can collect the data from the particular sheet. Now the because that workbook and that application and the workbook both are available virtually, right? So that from that workbook you have to collect the data. How we can collect the data? I am going to use one more action. See, get data from worksheet. So getting data from Excel worksheet, and then for getting data from the Excel worksheet, now we are having separate action, get worksheet as collection. I'm going to use this one, get worksheet as collection. And from this memory, that means from this instance, the instance reference we are having in this handle data item, from this instance, from which workbook? From this workbook. I am going to collect the data from which sheet? My data I am having in this sheet 1. So in this memory, I have opened this file. From this file, from the sheet, I am going to collect the data. The what format data will be available in that Excel? The Excel, it will be available in that tabular format, rows and columns order, right? Here, until now we have seen only the data item. The data item for what? Data item for storing value. But how many value we can store it in the data item? We can store it only single value. But the Excel data, it is not a single value, right? It is a multiple value. The multiple value, if you are using now, the data item will not support for that one, because I am collecting data from Excel. But I don't know how many columns and how many rows are, that means records available in that Excel. Okay, so Excel, if you are going to collect the data now, so you cannot store the data into where? Data item. So in that time only, that another stage coming into the picture, that is called, what is that one? Collection. So collection is one of the stage for storing multiple values. Clear? So we have to use the collection stage for storing the record format or tabular format data, rows and columns order. If you are having the data in the rows and columns order, now you have to use the stage collection. But here I didn't use any collection, right? The collection stage, you can drag and drop it here, the collection stage, and then you can open it. See, the property end of the collection stage, we are having three tabs: fields, initial value, and then current values. The initial value, fields, initial value, and current values, right? The same way, just I am going to take the data item, this data item for having initial value field and current value field, right? That initial value already we used, right? I have used for storing the default value, right? So the initial value place, if you are mentioning any value, now that value will be used as a default value. The current value, during runtime, what value assigning or storing in the data item, that value will be listed or displayed here. The current value purpose. The same way, here, this is collection. The collection's property window. But we are having that one more extra tab, it's called fields. Initial value, yes, the same purpose. The what are the values you are going to use as a default record format values for this collection, that values you can mention here. But if you want to assign or mention the default values in this initial fields, initial value tabs. Now, before that, you have to create the collection fields. That means the header. What are the column you are using or you are going to use? What are the columns you are going to use in this collection? So that column fields you have to mention it. So at the same time, without creating fields, that means column header name, we can use the collection. Okay, in the real time scenario, we will use the two types of collection. One is that with field, one is that without field. With field, if you are creating one collection, that type of collection is called defined collection. And without field, if you are using that any collection, it is called undefined collection. When we will use that defined collection and when we will use that undefined collection? So the defined collection, we can use it if you know that exact number of columns and what name is going to be there. In that scenario, we can use that defined collection. The undefined collection, when we can use it, now we don't know how many number of columns going to be there and what name is going to be there. Now in that scenario, we can use that undefined collection. Right here, which type of suits for our scenario? We are going to collect the data from this source file, right? This source file, we are having some fields. We know that what fields and what is the name for each field and how many fields. Those things we know that one. So then we can use a defined collection. So we can get the name for this one, student, and the sequence number. This is the field. If it is a field, you are going to store some value. The what type of values you are going to store it in that field. The data type, you have to select it. The data type you can select from this drop down list. I am going to use the number for this field. And second one is that name, and then what is that one? Name will be in the text. And third one, I am going to use it for percentage purpose. And then type will be number, and then department. It will be text, and the final one is that grade, which also will be that text file. So we have created our fields, the same number of fields only we are having in that Excel. That's what we have created, these five fields. And should I want to mention that initial value? Now, I don't want to mention that initial value here, because here I am not going to use that any hard code values, because I am going to collect the data from Excel. So that we don't want to assign any initial value. Suppose if we want to mention that any initial value for the default purpose, if there is no any data coming from that Excel, now in that type of scenario you can have that initial value fields, initial value section, you can assign the values. But now I'm going to collect the value from the Excel only, so I don't want to create that any initial values. And then current values, this tab will be enabled only during the runtime. Current values, you can see it only that runtime only, you can see it. We'll see later that one. And then click OK. That's it. So now we are having collection with a defined field, right? So defined collection. So this is the action for collecting data from the particular sheet. That information I am going to store it into, it is coming in the type, in the name of data, in the type of collection, right? Because the tabular format data. So that's what we have created, collection. This is our collection, and sorry. In the student, and fine. That's it. Select. All the stages are connected to the link stage. Then I want to execute only this page. Then set next stage, and then run to the stage. Run to the stage. Create instance. It's creating instance. And open notebook. See the student collection. Now we are having row 1 of 15. Open it. Initial value nothing, we didn't create anything, but in the current value you can see that all the data, what are the data loaded now. Okay, see all the 15 records are clear. So this is the way we can collect the data from Excel. So for collecting data, we have imported, or we are using one object. That object is called MS Excel VBO. If you are going to use the first time, now that MS Excel VBA object will not be available by default under the Object Studio. You have to import it from the local path. C:\Program Files, Blue Prism Limited, Blue Prism Automate, and then VBO folder. From that place, you have to import it. Clear?